is that crunch. Ooh. Thinking about the taste of your salad, think about what colours might go well with it. That way you'll make the simplest of salads instantly tempting.
Barbecuing chicken is controversial, and I'm constantly getting asked what the best method is. The trick is long, slow cooking. Now I'm going to make a fab chicken breast. It's stuffed with pesto, mozzarella and sun-dried tomatoes. So what we have here is a chicken breast, and we've battered it out. You get some pesto, put a nice big dollop in the centre, just spread it out. Just going to add some mozzarella, some sun-dried tomatoes into the centre, and we're just going to roll it up.
But I'm going to be making my absolute fave, which is salmon parcels with ginger and spring onions. So I've got a nice fillet of salmon on some foil, dunk on some spring onions, some ginger. Now in here I've got some soy, some rice wine vinegar and some sugar. I'm just going to pour it over. I'm going to get rid of my spring onions that are holding my foil down. And we're just going to fold this up and crimp the edges. Shape it as if it was a Cornish pasty. So then you just plonk it on the grill for 6 minutes where it will steam and bake at the same time. So when it's ready, take it off the grill. Now you need to be really careful when you open it up because of the steam. And there you have it, sexy salmon parcels. What you do is you pop in some overripe mango, chilli, garlic, ginger, juice of a whole lemon, juice of a whole lime, some sugar, a tablespoon of fish sauce, and finally some chopped coriander. Blend it for 30 seconds. This is really great for pouring over chicken or fish. My Thai mango sauce, it's yummy. So I'm going to use most of the same ingredients, but just kind of cut them back a bit. I've got these anchovies in here with some garlic. What I'm going to do is just completely mash them up. I'm not going to compromise on the cheese in this. I think it's really important. Just use it, but use it sparingly. And something like Parmesan is so strong, you don't need that much anyway. And my secret ingredient, zero fat Greek yogurt.
Is that instead of like egg yolk and oil?
Yeah, exactly. So, I mean, it does add a real creamy flavour. Have a taste. Perfect. And it's really good.
Oh, yum.
Got the toast. Would you grab that for me?
You're boiling lemons.
I know.
It's not normal, darling.
No, I know. It's a bit strange. But actually, this makes a really fabulous puree. I'm going to take them out now. Chop this in half. Pick out the pips. You're just going to get a real whack of lemon. Pop them in a food processor. Lovely. Wow, can you smell that?
Yeah, it's...
Oh, I'm looking for it to be pureed, but I do want some chunks, because you want a bit of texture in there as well.
I might give it little bursts of flavour as well.
3 eggs and some fructose sugar. Ground almonds. Plain flour. Baking powder. Whole lemon puree. Mix those through. So I'm doing this on a really low temperature. I'm doing it about 170 for about an hour.
Ooh, that looks lovely.
This is some chicken I've had marinating overnight for about 12 hours. Zero fat Greek yogurt and just some curry paste. That's some serious caper action as well. I love capers, so it's brilliant. I've made a marinade with barely any oil in it at all. I'm going to make a delicious garlic sauce. Rather than using a mayonnaise and oil-laden garlic sauce, I've made one out of zero-fat Greek yogurt. Garlic. So I'm just going to whack some of this beautiful parsley into this sauce. Gherkins. So this is just a flour tortilla, garlic yogurt, all over the top. Little gem lettuce leaves, tomato, gherkins. Jalapenos I find quite spicy, but I love them and they've got a real nice acidic kick to them.
You now have a nappy. A nappy wrap tortilla.
Exactly. I'm just going to tuck this underneath.
Proper kebab.